roll. Up in the sky, everybody so low. I keep me like foe, he sleep on the floor. He don't got no money, I show him the dough. Oh no, kick him, never with a bozo. Name in the mouth like froyo. With a rich baddie, looking for the bros. If he really would it, make him cash out the code, okay. Bro. Any, many, miny, mo. All this money, I need mo. Don't want your bro, it was for show, just so you know. We just wanna get lit. We just wanna get lit. We just wanna get lit. We just wanna get lit, 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 lit. Any, many, miny, mo. All this money, I need mo. Don't want your bro, it was for show, just so you know. We just wanna get lit. We just wanna get lit. We just wanna get lit. We just wanna get lit, 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 lit. Any, many, miny, mo. All this money, I need mo. Give him a show, killing your nose and taking your bro. Your man and spinning his bands. Oh yeah, did it again. Oh yeah, out with his friend. Oh yeah, Chanel is the lens. Okay. With his friend finna get lit. I'm everything on they wish list. Which bag should I get? Get which color should I pick? Pick any, mini, money, mo. All his money, I need mo. You big bro, gotta go. Big bird giving crow. A group of baddies coming foe. Give me money, kiss my toes. Don't with your bro, it was for show. Just so you know, we just wanna get lit. We just wanna get lit. For show, just so you know, okay. We just wanna get lit. 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 Lit, lit, lit. Any, many, miny, mo. All this money, I need okay. Mo. Give them a show, killing you nose and taking your bro. We just wanna get lit. Stop
Crystal. Look, I played the game, I missed the shot. I had the answer, then forgot. I knew one day my pop finesse, for not, my not, my not. For Lex and I fell out and cut the chip. My not, my not. Paralyzed the set, but I been taking hits like I can die like innocent. Morning of the day, the dawn of the dead day. I don't see nothing but red. I gather the blankets and milk and the bread. I come from the east and I'm traveling west. Got a machete, I chop it. The nigga, the serpent, determined, the plot and the threats. It ain't no stopping a run. Popping son of God, dropping anybody who next. I want a mansion, I got a million advances. I'm gonna stay in Atlanta. Most of them move to LA and throw all of their money away and move back with their parents. I see the canvas, I got the brush in my hand. The colors are mixing again, grabbing a stick with my hand. I drop my gush, the world is us. So what, who wanna touch, who wanna rough me up?
Nobody.
My head is ready to bust. Kicking the dough when I come at the cut. What? Yeah. Who wanna touch, who wanna rough me up?
Nobody.
My head is ready to bust. Do what I do and I say what I want. What? Yeah, mommy, your kid in the magazine, kid in the magazine. I had a stack on my jacket at Grammy. We see the audacity. I was a bad kid, bad city. You see the duality. Who tryna battle me, huh? Hitters is after me. Can I be dabbing me? Who wanna fuck me up? Fatality, really, it's up. It's up, undoubtedly. Baby, gon' touch the bucks. My salary double. Your baby daddy maybe triple. I'm trouble. I get the tackle in the pick and I hustle. I had to have it, had to get in the huddle. In the gravel and rubble. Got me a sack and I'm tryna be subtle. We just hacking like a dog with a muzzle. See the bagger, put him back in the puddle. We attacking, better stand back and watch a run. Shotgun, come with the option. Send big blitz, nobody blocking. Big win, that's a ring and a watch. Strong in when he come in a slot. Trying to bend the corner, your limbs getting. That's your partner, then your twin getting. All you wanna do is talk, I don't need talk.
Gotta hurry, somebody talk.
I can pull up with that, Chewbacca that. Banging my chest and my head on the locker. Feeling like walk a flock of flame. I put the opposition out the game. I'm out of pocket, but I rock with the game.
And the monster tip is out inside of me, so I'm like a product of power.
Who wanna touch? Who wanna rough me up?
Nobody.
My head is ready to bust. Kicking the dough and I come at the cut. Okay. Who wanna touch? Who wanna rough me up?
Nobody.
My head is ready to bust. Kicking the dough and I come at the cut. Okay.
First opened in 2002, there's a look inside Ford Field here in downtown Detroit, the Motor City. Both teams emerging from the Ford Field tunnels just a short time ago. And, of course, the loudest cheers were reserved for the hometown Lions. They're set to go as they will match up with the Washington football team. Getting toward the halfway point of the NFL season, Week 7 is underway on EA Sports. Braxton Berrios selected to bring it out and tackled at the 21-yard line, so a net negative there of 4 yards. Lions going to stop us momentarily as they call a timeout. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. Carry for the Memphis man, Antonio Gibson. He pushes through a would-be tackler to get about 3 yards, second down.
Now, this defense for the Lions, they played extremely well last week in that win over Green Bay.
And one of the key things you always look for when you're evaluating a defense is how opportunistic are they? How many takeaways do they get per game? And how about last week's game? That number, 6. Absolutely phenomenal performance. They were on top of their game right from the first snap.
And they're able to get this one across the 35.
So much goes into a successful play, doesn't it? How about that play action there, freezing the defense just enough to bring the tight end free downfield for the completion.
First down, love to pass. And the Lions pressure too strong. Down he goes. Coming up now on a 2nd and 15 following that sack. Love. Got his man complete over the middle. It's Hayes. The reception good for 7. It's 3rd down.
Brandon, perfect defense in this situation would have meant that there was an incompletion that would have picked it off. Okay, so they gave up the completion. But I really enjoyed watching how the defense stayed in sync, stayed in great communication, and as he dragged across each zone, you see him pointing, communicating, there he is, and they passed him off to each defender. Ended up making a nice play, even though it was complete.
Oh, that's into double coverage and intercepted. Picked by Jeff Okuda, and the Lions are going to take possession of the football as they force the turnover on the opening drive. Well, it's no secret he's had trouble this year with interceptions, and this is a bad start for him. First drive, throwing another pick.
No matter who's broadcasting his game, that's how the conversation begins. Throwing too many interceptions, can he take care of the football? If I were his backup, I'd be edging towards the coaches and saying, hey, how about giving me an opportunity?
This one out quickly to James. And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. Zero hesitation that time. That was get ball, throw ball.
Yeah, turn into a smoke route. If you see the coverage off the receiver, doesn't matter whether you call it a run or not. Just take the ball, get it out to him.
And they'll let the quarterback keep it here on 1st and 10. And that play will go nowhere. Losing yardage back near midfield at the 49. It's a loss of 4 on the first down play.
Sometimes you just sit back and marvel at what he can do defensively. Speed, strength, quickness, he's the whole package. And that package just wrapped up the runner for a loss.
They'll run for the first time with DeAndre Swift. And he's got it across the midfield stripe and into Washington territory. They'll get 4 on 2nd down, but it leaves him with 3rd and still 9 to go.
On any running play that's called, they're always hoping that it's going to break big and go the distance. But when you get a nice game like that, you're able to do so many things anyway. You can come back and run essentially the same play again, continue to move the ball on the ground, or you can decide to throw the ball now because usually you have the defense back on its heels.
And they'll get this one down near the 20-yard line, just shy of the 20. Really been an ideal start for them. They get the turnover on the opening possession. Now here they are moving the ball straight down the field on their first drive.
And that feels good, but you know on their side of the field, all they're thinking is finish this drive off because they took it away, right? So now you got them back.
Looking for Hockenson, and he's got him. Touchdown, Detroit. T.J. Hockenson. His 2nd touchdown on the season. And the Lions are going to take a first quarter lead. Extra point right down the middle. And it's now a 7-0 game. Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes.
Berrios going to bring this out of the end zone. And no chance to get away as they'll get him down at about the 17-yard line. Out there, set and ready for this next drive, the Washington offense. And they come into this one off the loss over the weekend. But you say if you're going to play a Thursday night game, this is the week to do it.
It certainly is, because you get right back out there. You don't have time to dwell on things. And look, your game plan is going to be a little more limited, but so is theirs. So that's when you just appeal to your top players. Guys, you make plays in this one, we out-execute them, we can walk away with a win.
Here's a quick throw out wide. It's McLaurin. Fighting to stay on his feet past midfield. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. So mark off the yardage for roughing the passer.
And I've seen this before. On a screen pass, not only are you rushing the passer, you're rushing him deeper than normal. And I think a little frustration kicks in at the end. You're going to hit him anyway when you shouldn't.
They'll try the left side with Gibson. A pickup of about 3 yards as he's taken down at the 31. Not a whole lot there. The defense was ready, it looked, for that run-pass option.
You get the sense that next time he has that opportunity, he may keep it himself and get to the perimeter. Probably owes his back a little bit of an apology on that one, huh?
3 yards on that last carry. Here's second and seven. Love now. That's going to be caught by Samuel. And he's going to get this down near the 20-yard line. Charles, Thursday night game, I think a lot of teams probably say shrink the playbook somewhat. Is that correct?
I think you're right about that, because you just don't have the amount of time that you have in a normal week to put in a full playbook. So, as you said, you shrink the playbook, pick out the plays that work best for you. You know what else you're looking for?
What's that?
Who are the freshest guys coming off of the last game to play on a Thursday night? Guys have a little extra pep in their step. You go to them early and often.
First down, going to the air with Love. Again, he'll find Samuel for the completion. And brought down, but not before they get it inside the 10 to the 7.
And these two hooked up on a nice game to play before, and I always admire play callers that see a play that works and go right back to it. So they went right back to him. The reward, they're set up with first and goal.
Love looking to throw it. Flush to his right, and that is incomplete.
Well, the gap man coverage on the outside, and my scouting report on these DBs tells me that they love to take matters in their own hands. They want man coverage, not zone, and there was good coverage there that forced the incompletion.
They'll try again here from the 7 on second and goal. Love from the gun. And this is taken in for a Washington touchdown. Curtis Samuel, his 6th touchdown of the season. And Washington now an extra point away from tying this thing up. Oh, shit. And now, of course, all scoring plays are reviewed, and I think they're going to take an extra long look at this one. They're taking a peek at whether or not those feet were in bounds, and obviously a big call here in the end zone.
And not just the feet. How about the hands? How's the ball possessed while the feet are hopefully getting down in bounds? That's what they're trying to look at to see if it all comes together.
An extra point by Nagar is up and good. And that will tie our score here in this opening quarter of play. So all even at 7 now as they kick it away. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. The Detroit offense ready to begin their drive. They are riding a 2-game winning streak into this Thursday nighter. How easy is it when you're on a roll to stay on a roll given the quick turnaround?
Well, you would think it'd be pretty easy because everyone's locked in practice and meetings, because everyone feels good about themselves. And for coaches, this is where they have to tell themselves, don't add too much. Don't worry about game plans as much as players. So look at your play sheet and think, give it to the guys who play best, and don't worry about the rest of it.
Now this one complete downfield on the left side. And he's going to be out of bounds right at midfield.
Let's make this one simple. What a catch, especially the finishing part of getting his feet in bounds, toe tapping, and of course, foot dragging.
A little tapestry, if you will.
Oh, I like it.
A gain of three, second down.
A 3-yard pickup brings up second and seven at the 47-yard line.
These two teams all tied after one.
The score tied 7-7.
Second and six. No, scratch that. Second and seven. He won't find a ton of space following the display of power as he's down just inside the 45.
A nice play design there with the touch pass. Looked good at the start, but bottom line, the defense was ready.
And they did a nice job scouting, didn't they? Not just scouting, but now executing once they saw the play for real after having worked on it all week in practice. They drilled on the play, then they drilled him.
Breaks the tackle, he's got room to run. And he goes down, but not before getting this inside the 25.
Well, that is a running back who is not about to go down easily. He fought his way through the contact until the seas opened up for him.
On first and 10, Franks escaping the pressure right. James has got it, complete. And down inside the 15, shy of the 10.
And this has been a nice answer to the touchdown drive against them a few minutes ago because they've come out and reestablished the tempo. A nice throw there, and they're putting together a very strong drive as a response.
On first down, here's Franks. He finds his man, complete. That's James. That will go as a pickup of seven on the seventh play of the drive.
And Washington now going to use the first of their three timeouts.
They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this second quarter.
Working with a second and three.
Got a man and he hits him in stride. And he gets halfway there from the four to the two on a gain of two.
And there's a completion to the tight end. And look at the size of these players nowadays. At that spot, 6'4", 6'5", and up. A lot of guys used to be basketball players, somehow came back to football. That's really good for the game of football.
And he's going to take it in for a Lion touchdown. It's their quarterback scoring on a 2-yard keeper. And the Lions have taken the lead. Extra point splits the uprights, and that makes the score 14-7. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. Berrios going to bring this out of the end zone. And his guys will get the football right at the 20-yard line. Out there set and ready for this next drive, the Washington offense. They trail a one-score deficit, 14-7, as they come up first and 10. Eluding the pressure right. And this turns into a nice gain with a slide at the end.
Partner, he was going through his progressions. Not there, not there. After about the third one, he decided he better pull it down and run for it. And he slides down and avoids the hit for good measure.
So they'll come up first and 10 now from the 33. Out of the shotgun, it's Love. And he fires one that's intercepted. Picked off at the 40.
And Brandon, this is a real nice job defensively of getting inside a quarterback's head and figuring out, okay, where is he going with the football? Because you can make an educated guess defensively, not all the time, but sometimes. And when you're right, you've got a decent chance of coming away with the football.
They hand off to their big tight end.
Give him 10 yards on the pickup, and that'll make it second and a foot or so.
What a way to start a drive. An excellent run, a tone setter, and now, if you want to take a shot on second down and go play action and make it look like the same exact play and throw it over the top, you can do so because you've established the run in a big way.
And he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. That backs him up 1 yard and brings up third down. On the option to give to Swift here. And Swift is not going to get there as they stop him short of the yellow line. He needed two, he got one, and that's going to leave him with fourth down and a yard. Franks. Oh, into a sea of defenders and intercepted. Picked off by Jamin Davis. And the return will stop them well inside their own 20 at the 15-yard line. So this is something we didn't see at all from this offense in the victory last week. That's a turnover. They didn't have any, but giving the ball away here in the opening quarter.
I love the surprise in your voice because it's exactly what you stated. Didn't see it last week, but it's a key to their win. And it'll be a key to this game as well, protecting the football. Didn't get it done there.
So the opening play of the drive goes backwards. Now they'll come up on second and 12. Play action this time with Love. Sliding out of the pocket. Well, this one taken in on the right sideline, but not in the field of play. They say it's incomplete. The throw led him a little too far and brings up third down. An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. Play fake. Here's Love. He completes this one to Terry McLaurin. And he is into the end zone for a Washington touchdown.
For as big and strong as some of these guys are, especially when you see them in full pads, it is sometimes hard to appreciate how truly fast they can move. That was incredible. Nagar now for the extra point.
And we've got a good one brewing. We're all knotted up at 14. This one tied at 14 now as he sends this one away. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. The Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive. And they had a nice little drive going last time through the interception in the red zone. Costly.
Bad enough to throw it anywhere, but that drives coaches insane when they're thinking about, hey, we got a shot at points already. We're already in a spot where you're thinking you've got three on the board for sure, and to come away with nothing, that's a really tough one for them to swallow.
Yeah, will they make up for it? Coming up at the half, a reminder, we go back to Orlando to check in with Jonathan Coachman. He'll have a look back at our first half as well as a look ahead to what's coming up later this weekend. Now Franks. Well, I'm not sure he saw the linebacker there as that's batted down and incomplete.
Anytime a ball's thrown in the middle of the field that's popped up in the air, I expect someone to catch. It doesn't matter whether it's offense or defense because there's usually a great amount of bodies in that part of the field. In this case, no one came up with it.
An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. Franks now. He's going to float this over the middle deep. That's incomplete, but there is a flag down. So hang on, a big call coming on third down.
Well, instead of fourth down after the incompletion, it'll be first down roughing the passer.
Coaches love their defenses to be aggressive, but they want them to be smart as well. Have to leave the quarterback alone at a certain point.
Quick hitter here, it's complete. And he'll take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds.
I like watching the wide receiver screen because it's a real teamwork play. Because guess what? The guy catching the ball, he'll get all the credit. But how about the people up to block in front of him, either fellow receivers or offensive linemen? That makes that play a really nice timing play, and sometimes it can break big.
And a big loss here as he's taken down. The Lions now going to use the second of their timeouts as they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming second down play. It's Franks now from the shotgun. This one caught. It's the tight end, Hockenson. A big gain there after going backwards, and that'll lead to a third down.
A gain of 25 yards. It's now third down.
The Franks looking to throw. And that is incomplete. Oh, he did everything but hold on to it. But a nice play defensively, and now it brings up fourth down.
It's now fourth down.
Now the Lions, they send out the field goal unit here. This officially a 55-yard attempt. And he has got it. From 55 yards away, that was never in doubt.
So he's been automatic to this point of the season, and he connects on the field goal there.
And what a luxury it is to have a kicker you can depend upon, partner, because he hasn't missed all year long. Converts on that one as well, and kudos to you. You didn't jinx him.
And he'll be brought down shy of the 20, so the decision to bring it out of the end zone, not a good one. They're set and ready for this next drive, the Washington offense. And they've got just over 50 seconds to go till halftime, so they can try to put something together if they want.
Still shedding tackles. And he'll be corralled well upfield right around the 40-yard line. A big play that time on the catch and run.
And they'll use him out of the backfield and sometimes quite a bit. They're just trying to get him touches any way they can. Four catches a week ago, there's another one right there.
Love's throw complete there to Berrios.
And he'll take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds.
But one of the ways the quarterbacks keep all the receivers alive in a play, never lock in on any one guy. Make sure you keep your eyes moving, scan the field. And here he finds the open guy for a nice pickup.
Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. Off the play fake, Love. And under the Lions' pressure, he's brought down. Now a timeout signaled for, and they'll get it with 10 seconds to go before halftime. So that complicates things a bit here. 18 yards to go now on second down. Another try after the first down sack. Love. He's going to fire one deep left sideline. And he's got it. What a catch on the sideline. Now a timeout called with 3 seconds to go. And, of course, they're in field goal range in the final seconds of this first half. So 3 seconds here remain in the half. On is the field goal unit to see about getting 3 points. This is a 40-yard attempt from the left hash. So thanks to the late field goal, we are all tied up heading to intermission. As we'll head down to Orlando, that's where we find our man Jonathan Coachman at our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach! Okay, Coach, thanks as always. This one's still anyone's game as we welcome you back for quarter number three. And ready to get the party started for the second half. It was an even first half, all tied on the scoreboard. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. The Detroit offense ready to begin their drive. It's a tie football game here. What do you think, Charles, the message was at halftime?
Well, I think that they probably just looked at things and said, we're fortunate that this is a tie game. No need to panic. No need to change a whole lot. We didn't play anything close to our best in the first half, so we don't have to go out and win one for the Gipper. Let's just go out and play our best football and win one for us.
So following the incompletion here, second and 10 from the 25. Now an option play, and he'll keep it. And boy, this burgundy and gold defense charged up now. They stop him behind the line again. This will be a loss of three, and now a much tougher third down looming. To throw. Franks, he's going to float this one deep right side. And that will be incomplete. Well, they weren't scared to let it fly, but it falls to the ground and brings up fourth down.
That's an excellent job right there on third down. Like any defense, you never want to let them get anything started, and that would have been a first down. Instead, you saw the contact on time, no penalty, and before this drive could get wings, it's fourth down.
39 yards on the punt, just two on the return.
And it will be Washington football now with a first and 10. Out there set and ready for this next drive, the Washington offense.
And after the field goal last time, we'll see what they can get here. At least they got points out of the last drive, Charles.
I never met an offensive coach that didn't want a drive to end with a kick. Most of them want to end with a PAT, right? In this case, a field goal, they'll take it. Way better than the alternative, which is a punt.
Yeah, but you met fan bases that wanted that. They weren't happy with that field goal.
I haven't met a fan base yet that wants a drive to end with a kick, other than the extra point. That's it.
An incomplete pass on second down leads us to third and inches. And he's got the first down yardage before being taken down at midfield.
That's quite a spot there for his first carry of the game, but obviously they had plenty of faith in him, didn't they?
No question about it. And here, why not go with the fresh legs? Able to push forward, pick up that first. From the midfield stripe, they'll look to throw.
That's out to the flat for Gibson.
And he's got some space here. Touchdown, Washington.
Antonio Gibson,
his fourth touchdown on the year.
And Washington has taken the lead. Nagar now for the point after.
And they will take a 7-point lead now.
Next is Washington 24. Lions 17.
Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive. And a tight game after punting last time. See if they can get something going on this drive.
As they head to the field now, with the game this close, you've got to feel there's a sense of urgency for them going on offense right now. But they have to do it without letting panic creep in and affect their play.
They had the run for no gain. Now they'll try again from the 25 on second and 10.
You got tight right there.
Check him. 38.
From the gun, here's Swift. And he'll wind up with about six, up past the 30 to the 31.
He had a ton of success here so far, but you get the feeling that he might be on the verge of popping one.
Yeah, even on that one, there was a little bit of a hole, but it closed there quickly at the end. Looking to throw. Franks. Toward the sideline. Did he keep the feet in? Yes, he got them both down, says the side judge. And that's good enough for a first down.
A little football 101 there. You just see the receiver try to run down the defender, meaning he goes right at him and really trying to move him a little bit towards the center of the field so he can put his foot in the ground and break to the out to the sideline and make a catch.
Call it a full 3 yards in the wrong direction there. Brings up second down. They'll stay on the ground with Swift. 4 yards on the pickup there, and now they're left with a third and 8.
It's interesting, going into this game, there was so much talk from both sides about who would control the line of scrimmage. I think we've seen who has it in this one so far.
Well, they bottled him up. He's barely averaging over 3 yards a carry right now. To throw on third down, Franks. And that is incomplete. Oh, he had a defender right there with him to force that to the ground. And fourth down now coming up.
My first thought is surprise, because that's one of the better tight ends around, and I've seen him pull in balls like this before. But how about a little credit to the defense forcing that incompletion?
So they're forced to punt on fourth as this one's away. Calls for the fair catch, makes the fair catch just inside the 15-yard line. Just 34 yards on the punt there, no return. And the Washington offense will be backed up to start this drive as they've got it first and 10. Out there setting ready for this next drive, the Washington offense. And they're hoping to redo their efforts in the last drive when they got into the end zone.
And just think of what it's like now on the sideline, because when you score a touchdown, you have to go over and look at the tablet and see what you did on the last drive. When you score points, it's a whole lot better view than when you're trying to figure out how to fix things there.
The 15-yard line.
Well, thanks for joining us here on a Thursday night in the NFL. Third quarter, second and 10 coming up. Love, they go play action now. He finds his man, complete. It's Hayes. And they work this well upfield across the 45. A big play that time through the air. 32 yards. Play action. Love to throw. They'll roll him out right. And for a third time tonight, he's intercepted. Picked by Tracy Walker. And he'll take it across midfield and down to the 48-yard line. Well, when he went on the move there and started rolling out, I thought there was a window, but that window closed quickly, intercepted.
And sometimes, despite how big your arm talent is, you don't get enough on a throw when you're on the move as opposed to setting your feet and stepping into one. That may have been the case there, and the defense certainly benefited.
40 yards on the ground for him so far.
And there we saw one of the downsides of blitzing during a rundown, because sometimes you get out of your gaps. You don't fit the run quite as well because you're headed towards the ball carrier with abandon.
Right back to Swift again on second down. Room here to run. Touchdown, Detroit. DeAndre Swift, his third touchdown now on the year. And the Lions are an extra point away from tying this thing up.
But I guess when you look back on it, it was just a matter of time until he popped a big one like that. And, you know, at halftime, you and I discussed it. They had done a nice job on him in the first half. But there were a couple of occasions where it felt like he might wiggle out of traffic and take it to the house. Finally here in the second half, that got done.
Nothing separating these two sides. 24 all our score as he sends this one away. Berrios going to bring this out of the end zone. And a good return as he'll be stopped just shy of the 30-yard line. Out there, set and ready for this next drive, the Washington offense. And their lead has evaporated in this third quarter. It's tied once more as they begin with a first and 10. 5 yards on the carry. Good pickup on first down.
Nice satisfying run on first down for the offense, picking up five, which means defensively, the thought process is entirely different. You don't want to panic, but at the same time, you're saying to each other, we've got to tighten this down. We can't give up gains like that.
Second and five now. Love. They'll dump that off to Gibson, complete. And he'll have it past midfield almost to the 40 before being taken down.
That turned into a very well-orchestrated play right there. Going to work his way out of the backfield to the right. And after he looked it in, he found plenty of space to roam and picked up big yardage.
So the ball moves into Lion territory now. Here's first and 10 at the 41. Gibson here running out of the gun. And this time not quite to the 30. It'll be down at the 31-yard line. One quarter remains here in this Thursday night matchup. We'll return with more after this. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. Good position to be in here, second and inches. Here's Love. And he'll take this into the end zone. Now, hold on here. We do have a flag down. So let's see what this is about. So they elect to decline it.
And why not? Just go ahead and let the play stand, and they'll take that.
Nagar now for the extra point. And they will take a 7-point lead now.
Makes this Washington 31, Lions 24.
The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. Franks now to throw on first down. He finds his man, complete. It's James. And this will be a gain of five as he gets it to the 30. Ball on the 30. They'll come up with a second and five. Back to throw. Franks. He finds his man, complete. That's James.
One thing you're hoping for when you run drag routes, you're able to hit a receiver in stride, and he can pick up a lot of yardage after the catch. But in this situation, the defense was effective, able to stop him before he could get a good head of steam going.
Throwing on first down, but this one winds up to be incomplete.
Tight end has become a bigger and bigger part of the passing game in the NFL, but if you drop the football, that position could get swapped out with a wide receiver in that spot, a running back in that spot. There are other ways they can go if you're not going to catch the ball.
And that's not just his first drop, his second drop of the game. Second down, Franks. Throwing left side, it's complete. And he takes this one down almost all the way to the 30. A big connection on that one. 30 yards. So the big play changes the complexion of things. Here's first and 10 just outside the 30. Again, he'll drop to throw. Toward the sideline, and look at that catch. Dragging the toes, and that's going to be a first down. Well done.
Like the design that we're seeing right there, this is what they need. Down by a touchdown here in the fourth. They just need to keep working their way downfield, and when they see openings, take their shots.
The drive continues as they search for a tying touchdown. Here's first and 10. They run out of the gun with Swift, and he'll take this one down near the 15. Credit him with a one-yard gain there to make it second and 9.
Brings up second and 9.
Working out of the gun, Franks. And he's got his man in stride, complete. And the Lions are going to have first and goal as they try to finish off this drive with 6 points. Swift, and he takes this one in for a Lions touchdown. DeAndre Swift with his second touchdown of the game, fourth of the year. And the Lions are an extra point away from tying this game here in the fourth. Don't forget the extra point. It's up and good. And partner, we've got a tie game here in the fourth. Set to go now with the kickoff. These two teams all even again as we continue in this wild fourth quarter. Berrios going to bring this out of the end zone. And he's up past the 20 to the 22-yard line.
Washington takes over first and 10 at their own 22-yard line.
They're set and ready for this next drive, the Washington offense. Well, they just gave up the score to tie it. That's the bad news. The good news, plenty of time in this fourth quarter to try to grab that lead back. On first and 10, Love throwing the out route and complete. It's Gibson. And this one will go to the 28-yard line. Under four to go now as the clock runs and they come up on second down. Working out of the gun, Love. And he slings one that's incomplete.
Well, to say that this has not been his game is probably a big understatement. I mean, he is all over the place. Mechanics are off, not accurate, except if you're playing on defense because they picked off a good number of passes.
Yeah, all the INTs, but they're throwing it off his back for pressure coming, just chucking it downfield. He can't do that right now.
No, you can't do that at all. And I think one of the hardest things for a guy having a day like this one is to find a way to just kind of get out of it, kind of get yourself back to neutral. Because what you try and do is make even more spectacular plays to make up for it, and it usually leads to more bad ones.
Both teams working on short rest, but this has been one of the better Thursday night games we've seen as they come up here on first and 10. Now a toss left side into the hands of his tight end. Now a second down and 6.
4 yards on the pickup. Second and 6.
Again, it's Love. He finds his man complete. It's Hayes. A gain of 4 last play. They double that here and get 8.
First down, Washington.
Jordan Love ready on first down here. Throw to the right here, taken in by McLaurin. And he's out of bounds as he gets this down to the 45. A gain of six there on first.
6 yard pickup brings up second and four.
From the 45 on second down, Love. He finds his man complete. That's Hayes. And it's going to be another first down as they'll get him to the ground at the Lions' 20-yard line. Getting down to the good stuff. All tied with 2 minutes remaining on EA Sports. So it's Washington with the football here as we welcome you back. They've got it first and 10 as they search for a go-ahead score. And he'll get it here to the 10-yard line. So fresh out of the two-minute warning, and here's another timeout taken with 1:55 remaining.
10 yards on the pickup. It's second and inches at the Lions.
In need of only about the length of the football here on second down. And he'll give it here to his running back. Yeah, he is met quickly in the backfield. Down he goes, folded like a lawn chair. It'll go as a loss of a yard, and it'll set up third down. Quickly now going to use the last of their timeouts as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. Tie game, fourth quarter, and they're going for this thing on fourth down. They'll go. It's Gibson. And he picks up the first as he's able to take it down to the 7-yard line.
Add that one to the good run tally right there. He's been strong throughout this game, and there's no reason to suggest he's going to slow down in the fourth quarter at all. And that's exactly what they need him to do. Keep churning out first downs.
A game-winning field goal would be a chip shot from here. Let's see how they play it on first and goal. They'll run with Gibson. And that's a touchdown as they've broken our tie here in the final minute of the fourth.
I don't know how many more of these my heart can take, my man. I just don't know. Another big touchdown. Late in the game, they look like they're in control. But still, there's a chance. Block the extra point, go down and score, kick the extra point themselves. They can pull this one out.
Yeah, but also on the sideline that just took the lead, you got to get your defense ready and the special teams unit for the kickoff coming up.
Yeah, you're exactly right. Got to pull everyone together and make sure they're still focused and aren't already celebrating a win.
And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. The Detroit offense ready to begin their drive. One possession game, time very much a factor. How does the offense handle this situation?
Well, in a lot of cases, they should be somewhat relaxed. And I know that's counterintuitive because this is a pressure situation. But this is Friday practice every week of the season. You go over this situation, having to go downfield, limited timeouts, got to get out of bounds and keep the drive going and set yourself up. Defensively, you can't just lay back and let them do whatever they want. So it is a cat and mouse deal here. How much pressure will the defense bring, and how much pressure can the offense handle?
We're going to find out. Being chased down left, puts it on the carpet, it's out.
And it's Washington that scoops it up.
And they're going to set up shop at the 32-yard line. And they were hoping to get down there, get the score, and get this thing into overtime. How deflating.
Absolutely. I mean, let's face it, heartbreaking. They had an opportunity, had a chance, and probably were feeling pretty good about what was going on, and that was taken away from them by their own mistake.
Yeah, the opportunity squashed.
So a victory here for the Washington football team.